What's up, guys? Welcome back or to the channel. Today we're going to talk about how to get your lifted Jeep or truck to drive as good or better than stock. If you guys didn't catch the last video, we were talking about how bigger tires affect handling and drivability and just overall performance of the vehicle. Now today I'm going to teach you guys, or tell you guys, exactly what I did to get my vehicle to drive basically as good as stock, if not better. So you'll know that after you put on your big tires and your lift, if you don't do any accompanying mods, you will have a little bit of wander, you'll have a little bit of slack in the steering, it won't feel great, and it's definitely not going to feel as good as it did before you lifted it. I'll tell you guys what parts I added and what steps I took to get mine to drive good, because it drives pretty much better than it ever has before, and I'll show you guys the reasoning behind getting all those parts. So let's jump right in and let's see exactly what you need to get. The first thing that I'm going to mention is make sure when you go to get yourself a lift or any accompanying mods or anything that you're going to be adding to your vehicle, to get the best quality parts that you possibly can. So if you guys can afford the cheapest parts, get the cheapest parts. If you can afford the top tier parts, get the top tier parts, and so on and so forth. If you can actually manage to get yourself something better, then go for it, because believe me, it will make a difference and it will ride that much better if you go out and get the correct parts, especially if you get better quality parts. I can tell you right away, I've got a Rough Country lift. It is not the best. It definitely does its job, but it is not amazing compared to something like a Curry or I don't know, just anything a little bit more expensive that has a little bit more quality to it. You will definitely feel the ride quality difference. So I do recommend getting yourself the best lift that you can. Now, that being said, the first thing that I would suggest for you guys to get after you get yourself your lift and your tires will be track bars, front and rear. Now, what is a track bar and what does a track bar do? Let me see if I can show you guys a little bit better underneath the Jeep here. So the track bar is that bar right there that connects from the axle all the way up there to the frame. And what that does for you is it centers your axle. You have a track bar front and rear. In the front, I'll be able to show you a little bit better. Here's your front track bar. You can see it attaches to the axle, comes up and attaches to your frame. And there is a ball joint on each end, and you can also get adjustable track bars. I do suggest going with an adjustable if you're getting a lift. That way you can actually get it to the right height and get it to exactly where you want. Now, the track bar centers your axle. So when you lift your vehicle, you'll find that sometimes you'll have one tire sticking out further than the other. And why is that? Well, that's because there's no track bar. So, or there isn't a proper length track bar, I should say. So you can see here how much tread I have sticking out. And you can see here how much tread I have sticking out. It's pretty much identical. And the reason for that is I got my track bars adjusted and I have an adjustable track bar in the rear. And when you go to get an alignment, get your alignment done at a shop that is used to doing alignments on four-wheel drive vehicles and lifted vehicles and just anything that is meant for off-road, because you will get yourself a better alignment. They'll know how to adjust all your different angles and all the different just arms and whatever else you have added to get you the proper geometry and make sure that your axles are sitting exactly where they should be. Now, the next thing that I would mention is control arms. As you can see, these ones are all adjustable. I've got adjustable arms in the front and the rear. This allows me to set the length depending on my lift. You'll be able to go up higher if you decide that you want to lift it up higher, and you'll be able to adjust those then. What the adjustable control arms also do for you is they allow you to move your axle to the proper position forward or back. So once you lift your vehicle, the axle is not going to sit in the same position it was. It's going to kind of want to come back a little bit. And that's not good for driving, that's not good for tire wear, that's not good for anything. So definitely make sure you go out, get yourself some good control arms. If you can, get adjustable control arms. And that way you'll be able to set the axle at the proper distance from the body or underneath the frame and get yourself set up and aligned properly. The next thing that I will mention would be a heavy duty drag link and tie rod. You can see this is my upgraded Curry centric tie rod, and I also have the accompanying drag link. So this is a solid steel bar. Sorry, I don't know why my tongue slipped like that, but this is a solid steel bar compared to a hollow bar that comes on the vehicle stock. Hollow bar will give you less leverage because it is gonna be it is gonna be prone to bending a lot easier. It will have more flex in it, and it will also be less strong. So if you do drive into a curb or a rock or anything, it's a lot easier to bend that tie rod than it is a solid bar. So upgrade your tie rod, upgrade your ball joints on your tie rod, and make sure that you guys get yourself a proper one for the size of tire and the lift that you have. That way you guys can actually get yourself rolling down the road properly and have a good steering feel and feel confident that you're not going to have any kind of issues with your steering. Because that's one thing that you can't really trail fix and get yourself off the trail if you screw up one of these. It's really hard to actually jimmy this together on the trail. And that leads me into my next point. Heavy duty ball joints. Make sure you upgrade your ball joints at the top and at the bottom of your knuckles on both sides, and make sure that you always keep an eye on your ball joints because you will wear those out a lot easier. Because your tires weigh a lot more, they're gonna take a lot more strain on your actual steering components. So ball joints, tie rods, drag links, anything that has to do with steering or moving the wheels, you're definitely gonna have more wear and tear. So if you can, get yourself some heavy duty ball joints, some upgraded ball joints. Don't get the stock ones if you can. If you have to, get the stock ones, but if you can possibly get yourself some better ones, get yourself some better ones. They'll last you that much longer and you'll have that much more confidence in your rig. Another component in the front that you're gonna wanna check is your U-joints. And I'm not talking about on your drive shaft. You will wanna check the ones on your drive shaft as well, but the ones I'm mainly talking about are the ones that are connected to your hubs. So the ones that are sitting right behind your actual bearing, you're gonna have a U-joint right on the axle shaft that connects your bearing and your hub to your axle. And basically, those are a weak point now because, like I said, now you've added more weight, you've added more stress, and you've added more strain to the vehicle. So definitely you're gonna wanna check on those, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you're not having any kind of seizing or any kind of dead spots in them where they kind of lock up, because if that goes on the road, like I said, that's a hard fix. That's not something you're basically gonna be able to take the wheel off and fix on the side of the road unless you're actually really capable. And it's definitely gonna be a pain in the ass. So go out there and check all your stuff, check all your steering components, everything in the front end basically that has anything connected to the axle. So your control arms, your ball joints, your U-joints, your drag link, tie rod, anything that connects to the axle, track bar, all of that stuff is prone to wearing out a lot sooner. So now you've added all of that great stuff. You've got your control arms, you've got your track bar, you've got your new drag link and tie rod, your lift, your tires, you're all set. You've spent everything in the bank and then some. Now it's time to get an alignment, and get your alignment at an off-road shop or at a shop that is used to doing alignments for off-road vehicles. Because like I said, some places, they won't actually know how to align all those different joints and all those different parts, because most vehicles don't have all those different adjustments and all those different points of adjustment. So definitely go and get yourself somebody capable, somebody that knows what they're doing, that feels comfortable doing it. And there, it's not that hard. You can honestly find a lot of different places. I would recommend 4Wheel Parts because they actually give you a digital readout before and after, and it gives you a little bit more confidence in knowing what you had before and what it's set at now. And it just lets you know that they actually did something because you have a digital readout. It's not just some guy in the back room going, yeah, I did it for you, and you drive down the road and your steering wheel is 45 degrees cocked to the left. It's not exactly right. And believe me, I've done tons of alignments where I've driven out of the shop and my steering wheel has been crooked. It's still crooked right now to this day. If you guys take a look at it, it's not perfect right now. And you can see my wheels are turned a little bit to the passenger side. So having my wheels turned to the passenger side and having my wheel turned to the driver's side, that's not right. And I have done my alignment recently. I've done it actually about 2 months ago. But I've been off-roading since that, and going off-road and doing things like that will screw up your alignment. And not to say that the vehicle won't track straight. If I let go of the wheel, it'll drive straight. It just doesn't have proper alignment of the steering wheel to the proportion of the actual drag link to the wheels. Whole mess. It's easy to fix. I can actually fix it myself on my driveway. I can show you guys how to fix that if you're interested. Let me know. I can drop a video for you guys. But let's keep moving on and let's go to the next step on how to get your vehicle to drive properly. Now, this next one may sound a little bit obvious or just a little bit like it's not that important, but rotate your tires. Definitely 150% rotate your tires. If you don't rotate your tires, you will wear your rears or your fronts, depending on if you're driving it four-wheel drive or if you're driving rear-wheel drive, you will wear them out a lot quicker. And then you're just gonna have to buy new tires that much sooner. If you do want them to last, make sure you rotate them at least every oil change. That's basically my rule of thumb. Every oil change, rotate your tires front to back. And if you're driving it with a full-size spare, you can also throw this into the rotation, take one of these guys off, put it on, put this into the rotation, and you have that much more longevity out of your tires. I personally off-road the crap out of mine, so I won't be doing that. I won't be throwing mine into the rotation. As you can see, mine is still fresh. It's got all of its hairs on it still. But the reason being is I'm probably gonna run through these tires a lot quicker than I will have time to actually let this one get old on me. So I will go buy myself some new tires, throw this one into the rotation at that point, and then I'll have another new tire on the back. Because I don't assume my tires are gonna last me too long the way I treat them and the way that I drive my rig. You can see I've got all kinds of chunks and gashes and all kinds of stuff missing from my treads. And that's just because I off-road the crap out of my Jeep. My next word of advice will be, after you finished all of that, check your tire pressure regularly. And I'm talking about like at least once a week. Like that should be the bare minimum. You should be checking your tire pressure a little bit more often than that. And you should be, and you're probably thinking, why? Are they gonna leak? No, they're not gonna leak just because they're big tires. But because they're big tires, they are more prone to changing temperature. They are more prone to changing pressures due to temperature. And you will notice that sometimes you'll come outside and your tires look a little bit low when it gets cold. That's because when you filled them, the air was a lot warmer than when you actually have it in those temperatures outside. Say it's 10 degrees outside. When you filled it, it was probably 20 to 30 degrees. And that air is now less dense. So you basically get less pressure. So now make sure you go and check your tire pressures, because when you have larger tires, especially with large lugs like this, you will wear them out a lot quicker, and you will also find that they do pull a lot more to that side wherever you have a low tire. And you'll notice it right away. You'll feel it. You might not see it because some of these tires, like these, I can probably take all the air out of here and you guys wouldn't really know, because they don't sit, they don't droop, they don't get that big bulge at the bottom. They're actually really thick and really stiff tires. So these ones I kind of have to just check. You can't really eye them out because you'll never know by looking at them. So guys, that's pretty much my advice. That's how I got mine to drive great. It honestly drives amazing now. And the last thing that I'll mention and the last piece of advice that I'll give you guys is, after you finished all of that, just keep checking for worn components. Make sure you go and you just do all your regular maintenance, but check for all those components in the front, like drag link, tie rod, control arms, ball joints, U-joints, anything that's connected to the axle. Just make sure that you see if anything's wearing out quicker than it should be, and if there's anything that needs attention or needs replacement. Because believe me, with bigger tires, it's gonna wear out quicker, and once you see that it has a little bit of an issue, you'll have less time to fix it because you have more strain on your system. So hopefully this video helps you guys out a little bit. Hopefully you guys get your rigs driving right and the way that you want them. Let me know if this video was helpful to you guys. If it was, jump down there, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, because it definitely helps me out a lot. And if you guys are interested in seeing this thing go off-road, I will be taking it off-road probably this weekend. So if you guys want to stay tuned for that video, make sure you jump down there, hit that subscribe button, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. So until then, guys, ride safe out there. Peace.